Welcome students. In the last video, I explained raw materials, steps and equations of photosynthesis. In this video today, we will discuss about the structure and function of stomata. We will also know about light reaction and dark reaction of photosynthesis and other minerals required by plants. After this video, you will be able to explain what stomata is, explain the structure of stomata, mention the function of stomata, and differentiate between light and dark reaction. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the structure of stomata. Before that, we must know what stomata are. Stomata are tiny pores present in the leaves through which exchange of gases takes place. Each stomata has a pair of guard cells which controls the opening and closing of the stomatal pore. When water enters the guard cells, it swells and the pores open. And when the guard cells lose water, it shrinks and the pore closes. I have drawn the structure of a typical stomata. You can see the structure. You can see the bean-shaped guard cells over here. A pair of bean-shaped guard cells are present, which swells and shrinks as water comes in or gets out of the guard cells. This is the stomatal opening, stomatal aperture, which widens or shrinks according to the movement of water inside the guard cell. This is the stomatal pore. These green patches you can see are the chloroplast present in the guard cell. So this is the structure of an open guard cell. Now, what are the functions of a stomata? The functions of a stomata are, first, it is the site of gaseous exchange. Students, we know that during photosynthesis, CO2 is required and plants take this CO2 from atmosphere. So CO2 is taken through the stomata. Again, during photosynthesis, oxygen is released out through stomata. It means that stomata helps in the gaseous exchange. This next function, the very important function of a stomata, again, it helps in transpiration. You must remember the definition of transpiration, the removal of water vapor from leaves. Stomata are the site through which the water vapor is removed out from the leaves. This is the site of gaseous exchange as well as transpiration. Students, in the last video, we have discussed about the photosynthesis. We discussed about the raw materials of photosynthesis, the steps of photosynthesis, and the equation of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, the entire step of photosynthesis is a very complex process. It is a very complex process, and the entire process of photosynthesis can be divided in two parts. Photosynthesis can be divided in two parts. That is, the first part is the light reaction or photochemical reaction. The second part is dark reaction or biosynthetic reaction. Light reaction is also known as Hill reaction, and the dark reaction is also known as Blackman's reaction. The photosynthesis can be divided in two parts, light reaction and dark reaction. The light reaction is the reaction or the part which are driven by the light energy. Light reaction means requires the light energy. This phase includes the very first step of photosynthesis, that is photolysis of water, where the water molecule in presence of light and in presence of some chemicals, some minerals such as manganese, chlorine and calcium, breaks down into its components. Water molecule breaks down into its components, and its components are oxygen molecule, obviously, hydrogen ion and electron. Here the photolysis of water takes place in the very first part of light reaction, where water molecule breaks up into its components and electron is released. The second part of light reaction contains formation of assimilatory power in the form of ATP and NADPH. The second part of light of photosynthesis is called dark reaction. It is actually a light independent reaction. It means this reaction or this phase can be completed in presence or absence of light. It requires the assimilatory power formed during the light reaction. This assimilatory power will be used over here, and here the CO2 molecule will be reduced to form glucose. It means the third, you must remember three steps of photosynthesis. First one was absorption of sunlight by chlorophyll and conversion of light energy into chemical energy. Second was photolysis of water, and third, reduction of CO2 to form glucose. So that third step takes place in the dark reaction. Its common pathway is known as Kelvin cycle. Students, apart from photosynthesis, plants also require a number of inorganic raw materials. Plants perform photosynthesis for the formation of glucose, but other than that, for various other functions, some other inorganic raw materials are also needed. These raw materials are very important for various different metabolic activities of the plants. It includes nitrogen, which is required for building proteins. It includes sulfur, which is again required for building proteins. And it includes phosphorus, which is required for synthesis of nucleotides. So these are some other inorganic raw materials which are needed by the plants. And from where do plants get these nutrients? You must remember standard 9 chapter where you have studied about macronutrients and micronutrients. Do you? Yes, you have studied about macro and micronutrients. We know that most of the nutrients are absorbed through soil. Some are taken from air and water. The plants take up these minerals by soil in the form of ions. So students, this is all about the photosynthesis and autotrophic nutrition. If you have any queries, you can ask the questions after watching this video.